Hello, happy people. My name is Lesya. For many years, I have been exploring batik and experimenting with. So today I will show you one of the ways you can draw, you can paint in batik technique. I will paint on cotton today, namely the cotton white pillowcase. To work in this technique, it's best to choose a white fabric. The colors lie in transparent layer, so background color always will be visible. So this pillowcase I previously washed and ironed. It's very important if you want to get very beautiful painting in the end. And now I will tell you what materials, tools we need right now. So first of all, we need to stretch our pillow or piece of fabric on embroidery hoop. I have small one, but it's enough. I think I can move it and I can draw. I will draw a few elements, I think. Easy to stretch, easy to remove. Look like this. And to protect backside of our pillowcase, you can put something from inside. I have some board. I'm gonna put it right here to protect the backside from colorful spots. You understand? Like this, so now ready to draw. So I placed my embroidery frame right here. Yeah, and here I have some space, so I'm gonna draw two big flowers. One will be here and one flower will be here. So here I have gutter resist, Russian one, and I'm gonna use glass tjanting for batik, and I need to transfer this liquid from this bottle to my tjanting. So only one way exists. It's transparent and it's very good because you can see when you need to stop to do it. Okay, and now we need to remove extra resist from our tjanting. It colored in light blue color. And now we can start.
Me. lonely days and lonely nights since you've been gone. I miss your touch, I miss your smile. Always by my side, I think about the times we had.
Contour drawing is completed, and now let's dry. Just leave it for 2 hours, and after that we can continue our masterpiece. So contour finally dried out, and before beginning to paint, make sure the lines are not too thin and that there are no gaps between them. Okay, start painting with the brightest color. I'm gonna mix white and red. Okay. white and red. And fill in fragment after fragment. Like this. Very carefully. A well-drawn outline is very important because it keeps the paint from going beyond the edges of the shape. Already dried, so friends, try your best in batik creations. Finally, I can relax, and as you can see, the flowers on my dress are drawn in the same technique. It means you can decorate not only home textile, but your dresses, your skirts, your clothes in this beautiful technique.